Hello friends, welcome to All Basic. Friends, today we will know about budget. Budget in Parliament. The Constitution refers to the budget as the annual financial statement. In other words, the term budget has nowhere been used in the Constitution. It is the popular name for the annual financial statement that has been dealt with in Article 112 of the Constitution. The budget is a statement of the estimated receipt and expenditure of the Government of India in a financial year, which begins on 1st April and ends on 31st March of the following year. Constitutional provisions. The Constitution of India contains the following provisions with regard to the enactment of budget. The President shall, in respect of every financial year, cause to be laid before both the Houses of Parliament a statement of estimated receipt and expenditure of the Government of India for that year. No demand for a grant shall be made except on the recommendation of the President. No money shall be withdrawn from the Consolidated Fund of India except under appropriation made by law. No money bill imposing tax shall be introduced in the Parliament except on the recommendation of the President, and such a bill shall not be introduced in the Rajya Sabha. It means budget is introduced in Lok Sabha only. No tax shall be levied or collected except by the authority of law. Parliament can reduce or abolish a tax but cannot increase it. The Constitution has also defined the relative roles or position of both the Houses of Parliament with regard to the enactment of the budget in the following way. A money bill or finance bill dealing with taxation cannot be introduced in the Rajya Sabha. It must be introduced only in the Lok Sabha. The Rajya Sabha has no power to vote on the demand for grants. It is the exclusive privilege of the Lok Sabha. The Rajya Sabha should return the money bill or finance bill to the Lok Sabha within 14 days. The Lok Sabha can either accept or reject the recommendations made by Rajya Sabha in this regard. Stages in enactment. The budget goes through the following 6 stages in the Parliament. Presentation of the budget, general discussion, scrutiny by departmental committees, voting on demands for grants, passing of appropriation bill, passing of financial bill. Voting on demands for grants. In the light of the reports of the departmental standing committees, the Lok Sabha takes up voting of demands for grants. The demands are presented ministry-wise. A demand becomes a grant after it has been duly voted. Policy cut motion. It represents the disapproval of the policy underlying the demand. It states that the amount of the demand can be reduced to ₹1. The members can also advocate an alternative policy. Economic cut motion. It represents the economy that can be affected in the proposed expenditure. It states that the amount of the demand be reduced by a specified amount, which may be either a lump sum reduction in the demand or omission or reduction of an item in the demand. Token cut motion. It ventilates a specific grievance that is within the sphere of responsibility of Government of India. It states that the amount of the demand be reduced by ₹100. Other grants in addition to the budget that contains the ordinary estimates of the income and expenditure for one financial year, various other grants are made by the Parliament under extraordinary or special circumstances. Supplementary grant. It is granted when the amount authorized by the Parliament through the Appropriation Act for a particular service for the current financial year is found to be insufficient for that year. Additional grant. It is granted when a need has arisen during the current financial year for additional expenditure upon some new service not contemplated in budget for that year. Access grant. It is granted when money has been spent on any service during a financial year in excess of the amount granted for that service in the budget for that year. It is voted by the Lok Sabha after the financial year. Before the demands for the access grants are submitted to the Lok Sabha for voting, they must be approved by the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament. Vote of credit. It is granted for meeting an unexpected demand upon the resources of India. When on account of the magnitude or the indefinite character of the service, the demand cannot be stated with the details ordinarily given in the budget, hence it is like a blank check given to the executive by the Lok Sabha. Exceptional grant. It is granted for special purpose and forms no part of the current service of any financial year. Token grant. It is granted when funds to meet the proposed expenditure on a new service can be made available by the reappropriation. A demand for the grant of token sum rupee 1 is submitted to the vote of the Lok Sabha, and if assented, funds are made available. Reappropriation involves transfer of funds from one head to another. It does not involve any additional expenditure. Today's question. Funds for the central government. The Constitution of India provides for the following three kinds of funds for the central government. Consolidated Fund of India, Article 266. Public Accounts of India, Article 266. Contingency Fund of India, Article 267. Today's word. Contingency. A future event or circumstance that is possible but cannot be predicted with certainty. Synonyms: eventuality, event, incident, occurrence, juncture, possibility, fortuity, accident, chance, etc. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe.